Hello, and welcome to the first episode of what is hopefully many to come, Frugal Ficus Gaming, playing FIFA 2022. I am your host, Frugal Ficus, and today we are starting a brand new career with Hartlepool United. I know that's what everyone came to watch, but it does continue a dear-to-my-heart tradition of taking a newly promoted team to League 2 and taking them all the way to the top. The hope is get them into the Premier League, maybe see some Champions League matches, maybe some FA Cup runs. And again, the whole idea for me is take the little guy all the way to the top. A little bit about myself and my acumen as a FIFA player. Haven't played my entire lifetime, but I have played for quite a while. I think my first FIFA game was FIFA 09, so I'm well versed in both the joys of playing, as I obviously have stuck with it, but also the flaws, and there are many, I will admit, but I have found, for me personally, it's the most enjoyable on FIFA video, excuse me, soccer video game experience, and so that's what I'm presenting here today. So a little bit now about the career mode. Went with Hartlepool because, again, they are one of the teams promoted last year to League 2, which is the fourth division in English soccer, and it is the lowest available in this game. And then as the manager, we've gone with a little bit of patriotism and a nod to the late, great Katherine Johnson. For those of you who don't know, she was a brilliant mathematician and NASA scientist. And we've gone with a nod with her for the design of the character, but we also updated a little. 2022, went with some purple hair, and I guess a minor shout out to Ellen Rose from Outside Xbox. So shout out to her as well, and all the great content they produce. But enough of that. We're here to play soccer, and as such, you're finished reading that wonderful journal article, we will go and get into it. So I promise not to talk the whole time, but I do want to get some initial things squared away. This video is probably going to be a bit slow. We're setting up the team. I'm going to my classic 4-3-2-1. I really would call that a 4-3-3 personally, especially after we drop this midfielder into defensive midfield. Okay, let's find some good positions for people. So looks like Shelton doesn't have a penalty for holding, which is good. So for those of you who haven't played FIFA before, one, thanks for stopping by. I'm shocked and amazed that you found this. But FIFA has evolved, and various, I think, qualities have come and go as EA Sports experimented with things. Longtime players will know that the loan-to-buy system came and went. It is back now. And then another thing that someone will correct me if I'm wrong, I think was available in earlier games was this plus-minus system. You can see I've got a... because of the formation change, there's a center back currently in the right forward position, which would obviously not be where a center back would play normally. And so he's got a giant negative rating attached to him. And you see as we swap in a striker, they don't mind it as much. There's no negative penalty associated with them. I can't say I'm entirely well-versed in exactly what that means in the game, but obviously a negative score is worse, and a positive score is better. Again, as it do, I think with just player performance, I don't think player morale is affected. But again, I could be wrong, and I'm sure someone will tell me if I am. Sterry, I recognize that name. I believe he played for Newcastle at some point. And now he's down with me. Good for him. Probably bad for him. But we'll take him. Alright, so the early thing whenever you take over a team, I like to look who are the players we have, Do we have any promising young talents? 22 years old, that's not too bad. 25, make over the team. He looks young by his headshot. He is 21, fantastic. We will keep him. Sterry, again, 25. 28, that's our veteran, maybe. 27, not great, not terrible. Shelton's 24, that's good. He's got some room to grow, hopefully. Holahan. Okay, I think he's going to be our veteran presence. Oh no, Featherstone. I spoke way too soon. Featherstone, though. Sorry, Featherstone. And again, I find that really odd. Sometimes he's listed as a central defensive midfielder, and yet he gets a positive bonus for playing in central midfield, whereas Shelton, the other way around, not even listed as a center defensive midfielder, and he gets a bonus. It's weird. I would almost guarantee it doesn't correlate to what the players themselves feel in real life, but at the same time, I think it's a fun little feature. You get to play around. There's some surprise, a bit of unknown when you acquire a player as to where they're going to fit in the system. I think it makes it a little more challenging and again, a little less predictable, which personally I appreciate, even if it's not entirely accurate. Okay. But with that said, that's our main game plan. And then our attacking style. I like to keep the same formation for at least our base and then attacking and defensive. Ultra attacking and ultra defensive is when I tend to mess with the formation, excuse me. And that was silly. And that's really just because I feel there's too much shifting going on. You'll get players out of position. And I do like to switch between, you know, that attacking style, go defensive when we're not in possession, and then push out when we have the ball. I find it's the best for the AI players to show up in the right places, and also maybe it's mostly in my head, but it makes me feel like we're doing better. So back to why I like that 4-3-3 formation. I feel there's a nice amount of flexibility wherein I can take this central defensive midfielder, and if we're in defense, you'll see I'm going to shift them back here and then bring one of these two over in here. Actually, it's really going to be dropping him, and then we'll have a two cent. It'll make more sense. Hold on one second. So defensively, let's do defensive first. So that's actually not far off of what I like to do anyway, but I do like to invert that triangle in the middle so we have the attacking player. Ooh, I'd like to continue adding. So you see we got two strikers. That actually works well because he doesn't mind that as much. Okay, so he'll be our attacking midfielder. Keep these guys in, and then here he is. Here's the guy who I like to, and that actually works perfectly fine. I like to drop him in to the back line, so we can make it a back five. And what that does is just really gives nice defensive stability when we're protecting the lead, or I feel like the other team is pushing. This works out really great because we have wingbacks, so they actually want to be out there and up a little bit. But again, you have that nice spine going through the entire team, and then you get the nice back five. But inversely, if we want to go all out attack, we still... not him. Shelton. We still pull that defensive midfielder into the back three. We really throw the wingers up the field. He doesn't like it, but he's going to like it anyway. And then we keep that same sort of midfield structure. So you see our central defensive midfielders really never move, regardless of what the formation is. All at attack, they're still there. The difference is we're dropping the central defensive midfielder all the way back. And that's either for going into a back three and then really throwing the wingers up, or if we're going ultra defensive, we pull him back into a back five, keep our fullbacks, excuse me, I think I said wingers and I meant fullbacks. We keep our fullbacks back, we collapse everyone, make it nice and narrow, and then just hold and park that bus. But that all being said, this is a formation we're going to play in quite a lot, so we want to make sure we have players who are good at it. As it looks right now, these guys are pretty darn good. So honestly, I'm feeling quite optimistic. And I will say, I have not played this team previously. I've played FIFA 22, obviously. It's been out for a while at this point. But I haven't actually played this team, as I actually got the game a little bit late. Just wasn't feeling it at the time. Alright, next thing to do, now that we've gotten all hopeful, is find out how many players are on loan. Okay, only one. That's not bad at all things considered. Normally with League 2 teams, as in real life, you see a decent number of loan players. Because they obviously can't afford to buy them outright, but they can take some of their wages from higher tier clubs, get a high, nice quality player for a year or two, and try and use them to promote themselves. But it looks like Hartlepool is not following that trend, and instead, everyone's contract is going to expire next year. Okay. Well, not ideal. First things first, let's do our first ever contract negotiation on stream. Obviously, I've done this before. And see if we can get Timmy. I like that name. We would like to get Timmy for a lot of years, because I see him as a key player for our back line. So here we go. We get our first game sound. I'll have to check through audio, so make sure that's okay. Now, let's see. I think he should be an important member of the team. He thinks he should be crucial. In my experience, that's never negotiable. Just say, okay, 3 years. I think that sounds good. I don't think we're looking to do too much more. It's going to depend on how he progresses. I don't want a release clause because I don't want to get tied into having to either let him go or pay him more money. And I will be honest, I like to keep you at the same salary, and we'll give you, that seems like a lot of money for a tiny team. Give you $8,000 to say yes. Now, I know there are seasoned FIFA players out there who are probably yelling at me, telling me I could have gotten him for less money and wouldn't have had to pay him a sign-on fee, and I know that's true, but I don't want to necessarily exploit this game so much as play it a little more realistically. I don't think any player out there would accept lower wages without a signing bonus. So I will strive in this game not to offer a player less money than they are currently making, unless there's an incentive in it for them, like a release clause or a huge signing bonus. I can't guarantee I will absolutely 100% stick to that, but that is kind of the goal. In the same vein as that, another kind of self-imposed rule that I'm going to put in is free agents. I've felt in this, you know, FIFA 22, this version of the game, they're a little too strong, particularly with high-profile players who just hit the free agent market and are available to anyone. And while that somewhat emulates real life, this club in particular isn't going to be able to sign them. Now, I do know this game has instituted a really cool feature, in my opinion, where some of those players absolutely won't sign for you. I think something along the lines of not willing to sign for a less competitive league, I think is the wording they put in, which is really cool, but still feels a little cheaty to me. In terms of the quality of player you can get. So a self-imposed rule is I'm not going to sign any free agents in the month of July. I'm going to wait till August, and we'll open it up again in January. And that's to let some of the really high-quality free agents filter out to make it feel a little more realistic. And then from there, I don't have to self-limit myself as much in terms of saying this player wouldn't really be available in real life because they've been on there for at least a month and the game has told me they're fair game. Let me know in the comments if you think there's a better way to do this. I'm certainly open to suggestions. This is just what I've come up with. And so we're going to do that. But what we will do is we will look at who's available and at least scout them so that we have some idea of a player that might be available to us. Marinovic, I have owned him previously. Obviously never on this team. So we will investigate him and figure out whether he is going to be available in a month and willing to sign. Fiola, I do think he's quality, maybe. A lot of green, we like green, especially this low in the league. Another thing, let me know in the comments if you guys are interested in seeing any of this. I can alternatively do most of the administrative player signings, wage contracts off camera, and then just do the games on camera. Right now I'm just going to put everything on camera and then let you guys decide what you don't want to see. Juka Oliver. So, he is one who, without the self-imposed limit, I think I would sign immediately. Because he is obviously very young and looks promising enough. He's got good standing tackle, that's always helpful. Strength is high, aggression, stamina, 6'3". I'm a sucker for a tall center back. So he's one I'm hoping is available in a month. And I knew it. We ran out of scouts. So what we're going to do is I'm going to pay a little bit of money to sign a scout. I'm going to have to spend more money than I want. That's a lot of money. I shouldn't be using that here, but I want to know what these players are. I got to know. Faster than my girl. Oh boy. Matthew, my friend, my pal. I don't know him in real life, but I have played with him previously on other teams. Never played with you. I don't know who you are. And basically, I'm just going through looking at a player's stats, some of its past knowledge. I've played with a couple of these before, and some of it's, again, just looking at their stats. You see green, that's generally good. Red's generally bad. Interesting to me that he is not great in strength as a defensive midfielder. Something to kind of keep in mind, especially on higher difficulties. I feel like I can tell when a player is not very strong. I don't know if it's true or not. Balintvas? I don't know if that's how his name is spelled. Okay, interesting. So I would actually like to know if he's any good. So we're going to take that one off. Mohamed Jamal. Save him for later. And I want to know. Yes. What are you like? You have physical skills. Not great technical skills. Okay. Reasonable. You're 16 years old. Well, my junior, make me feel very sad. But good for them. Okay. Check our email. As is riveting to do. And look at our absolutely abysmal youth squad. No offense to any of these fake players, but I view you as terrible. Alright, we do have an Egyptian goalkeeper that is somewhat interesting. 54 at 17, doable. The potential is rather high, which is nice. If we could keep that 94, that'd be swimming. But I honestly don't expect that to happen. So we shall have to see. Okay. Let's see how the no. No, I don't care about training days. Someone let me know if training days are actually interesting to them, and or sorry, useful to them. I have yet to find them ever since they were introduced. I think it was a couple. I think it was FIFA 20. I have yet to really find a benefit to them. Or I take that back. I found a benefit to them when you were targeting, you targeted or like five players, and you could create really good players from the youth academy by sort of training them constantly. I think I remember doing that with goalkeepers a lot. But I think it was FIFA 20 that they changed that to the system where it is now, where you can just train a bunch of players at sort of more generic drills. And I just don't find it worth it. I feel like they stay sharp through the season regardless. And so I'm not going to waste time doing that again, unless someone finds it interesting or would like to contradict me and say they find it useful and or worth doing. I'm always open to new information. That being said, let's do our first preseason game. Let's see how they do, and then we'll probably end this first episode there. Let's see how it goes.
Hello and welcome to the Signal Iduna Park. I'm your match commentator, Derek Ray, and ready to provide expert analysis alongside me is Stuart Robson. And we have pre-season group stage action from the
yes,
European International Cup coming up for you. Stuart, your expectations?
Well, thanks, Derek. Now it's time to see whether this initial fitness training and development of tactics has been successful. Will there be any change of formations? These games are great to assess how these teams are evolving.
We'll do a change of formation. And as I've so expertly explained, it's going to be perfect.
Making excellent progress with the ball at his feet. Can he give them the lead? And a goal! They start as they mean to continue. They make the opening statement.
Okay, I'm not gonna lie. I feel like the difficulty's not set correctly, because that seemed easy. And I say that, and I'm sure I'll just give up three goals right about now. Hopefully, very important. Hopefully, it's the winning goal. Maybe. Sir. Oh my.
Well, he's given us away.
Ooh, that was a bit,
well,
bit close.
Following the changes at the club with a good deal of interest. New manager at the helm.
Yes, there is.
Smiles and handshakes before kickoff.
That's
if
fair.
You feel, don't you, it's vital she gets off to a quick start.
Well, as with any
sir.
New manager, she'll want to get her ideas across very
quickly. Oh, Stuart, they could be in here.
Okay, the difficulty cannot be set correctly. I apologize if it is not. I can't check it here. I can't check it here. Okay. Well.
Well, a second goal for them here.
I apologize, because this cannot be right. I am torn as to what to do, because I obviously have not saved the game since I made all those changes. Don't particularly want to go through a restart during a recording. So I think we're just going to stick with it, see how it goes. I could be wrong. Maybe this team really is terrible. Okay, maybe this team is really terrible. They did just dribble out of bounds. Not that I've never done that. I can't lie to you. Can't start like that.
In the center.
Let that one get away from me. Alright, here we go. So actually we'll go ahead and come defensive in case I'm wrong and the difficulty is set correctly. No, no. Bad. Bad.
Into the advanced position. Could play it in.
Nice tackle. He's off. Oh, he's not off. Got back on.
Deal with the threat this time. And here's Moula. Well, they no longer have the ball.
So as you can probably already tell, I am a fan of playing out of the back. I think goalkeepers have feet too. And should be able to pass competently. For the most part, it doesn't screw you.
Ooh.
Fair.
He's driven in the corner. Not a bit short with the clearance. A goal! And it seems that truly.
This seems. This is a strange feeling, I'm not gonna lie.
Well, here's the replay, and you can see why.
Normally, I get waxed in the first game.
Area, and at this level, if you keep doing that, you're gonna get punished. It's just not good enough. So the whistle then, we're at the halfway stage.
All right.
In this match.
Well, halftime team talk. Not much to say. We're doing really well.
Days, not at all, Stuart.
Yeah, I've been really disappointed with him today, Derek. He just hasn't looked himself. But
I've been disappointed with him too.
He hasn't had great service, has he?
It's because of that all-star defense. That I can name. That includes Timmy and Sterry. Don't know the other two yet. I'm a bad manager.
Excellent progress with the ball at his feet.
That one right there. That, I don't think. Well, we will find out at the end of the game. That's all I can say. But halftime team talk. Guys, we're doing great. Keep up the good work. Keep up that pressure, keep putting those shots on goal, and just keep keeping on. Oh good, and we get the ball first too.
To have a go at each other again as the second half commences. Burn, well, keeping hold of the ball is what it's all about for them.
Yeah, darn right it is, with a 3-goal lead. I'm going to keep the ball the whole half. It's going to be a very boring game. Sorry. I promise we will lose a lot of games. Just maybe not this one. Which is good, because the preseason is a great time to pick up some cash. It's another thing that feels a little overpowered. You can get like $1 million just for getting out of the group stages in these preseason tournaments, which... for a small club is big, at least it is to me, because it helps me buy youth scouts, which is another key pillar of my management style. I should stop talking about management style before the game's over, because I'm losing the ball. That's okay, they're terrible. No, keep running, people. Oh, poor. Also, I did have it on defensive, so my bad. Ah, Featherstone, right? Yes.
Teammates in the middle, unable to trouble the defense with that cross.
Ooh. Okay, we're just gonna clear that. That was bad. Let's not do that again for all of you. I apologize. Mostly apologize to my goalkeeper's face. I think that counts as a save, though, so I'll take it. Oh, that was bad. All right. That's, I guess, the argument against playing out of the back. That probably should have just been a hoof it upfield from my keeper. But instead I tried to dribble. No. He does like to run at them, and I don't appreciate him running at them. Yes. Dribble that ball right out of bounds for me.
And they will make the change now. Losing possession here.
Shelton needs to get back in the box. We're on thin ice. Oh no. Okay.
Well, just look how he holds off the defender. He keeps his balance and he still hits the target.
I'm starting to get a little nervous.
No shortage of goals on this match. 3-1.
15 minutes to ruin the perfect start. Well, they've already ruined the perfect start. Perfect start would have been keeping a clean sheet.
Well, possession is the watchword inside their own territory.
What? Give me that ball. That seems...
Philip. And he takes on the shot.
Alright. So as you've seen, my I have gotten nervous. We're going full defensive. Which I will justify by saying I'm a coward. And I'd like to have the first game be a win. You know, it's important for a new manager. First game. You want to be a win. Get off the drop.
Oh boy.
I'll pretend that was exactly what I meant to do, even though it was nowhere close. Ooh, they're pressing high. Oh, what the hell was that? Oh, no. Okay, I promise that wasn't for the drama. I was trying to do a full field cross, and that was atrocious. I want instant replay on that because I wanted to show who I was actually aiming at. Yeah, hold on. Hold on. You have gotta be kidding. Oh, that's terrible. Okay. Well. Oh well. I would not have. Particularly the part about us having three. We are going to have a high press here at some point, and I would like to avoid it for as long as possible.
There will be 1 minute added on at the end.
Perfect. Yes. Okay. Yes, that little bit at the end was cowardice, but I will justify it slightly with that abysmal crossfield switch. That was aimed at the left wing back, not the left center back. But Luke Molyneux, go with that. Should probably learn his name if he keeps doing that. Okay, so I'm gonna guess it actually is the right difficulty, and I just got super lucky. By super lucky, I mean super talented. Oh good, and we don't have to do press conferences during preseason games, because no one cares what I say. Alright. Well, okay, hold on, let's go ahead and check these settings. Wow, it was ultimate. Well, with that fantastic news. I'm going to close episode 1. Thank you for joining me, and I hope you come back next time.